Welcome all to first class of vectors. In this, basically we'll discuss what is scalars, what is vectors, and what is tensors. So first we'll discuss what do you mean by physical quantities. Physical quantities means the quantities which can be measured are known as nothing but physical quantities. So in physics, basically we'll discuss about physical quantities. That means something that we can measure. Means we can measure the length of an object, we can measure the mass of an object, we can measure the weight of an object, we can measure force acting on an object, we can measure speed, we can measure velocity. So something which can be measured is known as nothing but a physical quantities. Now these physical quantities are classified into two. One is known as scalars and another one is known as vectors. Scalar quantities means the quantities which are represented only by its magnitude. So that means like if you are representing mass of an object, so if you are just writing the mass of an object is equal to nothing but let's say 10 kilogram, so only that much information is required to specify that mass is not having any direction. Same as like length, time, speed, etc. can be taken as the example for a scalar quantities. So scalar quantity means we can represent it only by using its magnitude, no need for its direction. Next one is known as something with vectors. To define a vector quantity, we require both magnitude and direction. And one more thing is that it should obey vector addition rules. So we'll discuss in coming topic what is vector addition rule. So we can say that if there is a vector quantity, to specify that vector quantity, we need to specify its magnitude as well as direction. Like if you are saying that a force of 10 Newton is acting on an object, which is not representing the complete description of that particular force. Along with that 10 Newton, we should specify in which direction that force is acting, whether it is going to act towards right, left, upward, downward, etc. Same as like if you are taking another example like displacement. So if you are saying that an object is displaced by a distance of let's say 5 meter. So along with that, we should specify in which direction that object is displaced. So if you are saying that a displacement of 5 towards right, then object may reach over here. And if you are saying that an object is displaced by a distance of 5 meter towards left, then the object may reach somewhere over here. So we can say that this displacement, we can completely represent this displacement only if we are representing or specifying its magnitude as well as direction. So such a quantities are known as nothing but a vector quantities. And one more thing, it should obey vector addition rule. Now I'll discuss about tensors. Tensors means a physical quantity having both magnitude and direction, but not obeying laws of vector addition. So there are some quantities like an example, we can take electric current. So if you're considering an electric current of 1 ampere is passing through a conductor in this direction, and another of 1 ampere is passing through a conductor, something like this. And if another conductor is over here, then the value of net current passing through this will also be equal to nothing but just the sum of these two, that we can take it as that is equal to 2A. So irrespective of in which direction these currents are coming, its sum will be always equal to nothing but 2 ampere. So it is not obeying that vector addition rule. That means even if a current of 1 ampere is moving in downward direction and a current of 1 ampere is moving in upward direction, the resultant current over here or passing through this conductor will be equal to 2A. But if you are considering a situation, if you are having an object of mass m over here, and if a 1 newton force is acting in upward downward direction and a 1 newton force is acting in upward direction, the value of net force will be equal to 0. So over here this force is obeying this vector addition rule, but this current is not obeying this vector addition rule, even though it is having magnitude and direction. So these quantities which are not obeying vector addition rules are also considered as nothing but a scalars. Means this tensors which are having the tensors are also considered as nothing but a scalars. Hope so that you understood what is scalars, vectors and tensors. If you are having any doubt or if you'd like to interact with me on live classes, or if you want to write online tests for JEE Mains, Advanced or NEET, or if you want to solve more number of questions, so please let me know. Thank you.